Hello everyone, I'm Caleb Low and I am a member of Team Singapore Debates. This video is part of a series targeted at helping younger debaters grasp the rudiments of debating, especially in this trying global time. With that, I would like to give a short lecture on how to choose examples for debates. To be clear, there are no hard and fast rules for when and how to use examples, and this has to be determined by your team via a consensus method. Secondly, there are no one-size-fits-all ways to force examples into every single debate. A discussion on banning smoking, for instance, would likely be very example-light, as no country has ever implemented such a policy before. Therefore, debaters cannot simply apply the same method to examples into every debate, but must look at the specific nuances of the motion before deciding how to use examples. Nonetheless, examples form a core part of any debate case. Even if you do not believe that examples are useful in case construction, you will often meet teams in the circuit who use examples in extremely heavy ways. Therefore, learning to respond to those teams requires you to understand how examples can and should be used within debating. With that, I would like to discuss two ways in which examples can be used in a debate. The first is that examples can be used as a form of persuasive analogy. You can say that since X has been done in a previous set of circumstances, it stands to reason that X should be done within the present circumstances of the motion. For instance, in a debate about implementing sanctions on Venezuela, you can raise examples of how sanctions have also been used in Myanmar, Russia, or South Sudan. The key to using these examples is to prove that the circumstances within those countries are comparable to those within the motion given to your team. Secondly, examples can also be used as a way of illustrating a mechanism. They can make your argument seem more fleshed out and concrete. For instance, in a motion about this House supports is that UN standing army, teams might be sent into theoretical discussions of whether a standing army or the UN peacekeepers are a better actor. If proposition were to raise the example of Rwanda, where peacekeepers were wholly inadequate and a standing army could have helped stop the genocide, it would poise proposition in a better position to win the debate, as their arguments seem to have much more impact in the real world. Here are a few guidelines on choosing examples. The first is to choose examples that are as recent as possible, as historical examples tend either to be overused or outdated. Secondly, you should use a wide variety of examples from different geographies and countries. This shows the universality of the policy that you are arguing for. At least now, there seems to be a heavy US-centric method with which most teams approach debates, often using examples on the political and judicial system in the US as part of their argumentation. If you are able to branch out from this and use arguments from other countries and regions, it would definitely make your arguments seem a lot more persuasive. Finally, do not use examples which are overly controversial, as these rarely help to prove your point. In a motion, this House would toughen drug laws. The war on drugs could be used as an example by proposition, but this would be unwise as it is still hotly debated on whether or not the war on drugs was a success. Therefore, you should abstain from using controversial examples and use those that are clean-cut instead. There are some pitfalls to avoid when using examples. The first is that some debaters fall into a trap of substituting examples for analysis. This occurs frequently in motions where examples are thrown around by both teams to prove their case. In the motion, this House regrets the involvement of celebrities within politics. Names like Donald Trump and Arnold Schwarzenegger are likely to be thrown around. It would be unwise for a debater to merely prove that Donald Trump has been harmful to US politics and then generalize it to the entirety of the motion. Examples need to be viewed as embellishments to arguments and not points in and of themselves. Additionally, teams should be aware of how examples can be flipped against them in any debate. If one were to say in a debate that China is an example of capitalism success, they must be preemptive of the fact that the opposing team will assert that China's economic system is unfair or that its success has been overblown. Therefore, in order to ensure that your examples remain persuasive throughout the bench, you have to ensure that your examples are well constructed and insulated against very clear refutations. Practically, we have to ensure that we collect examples in our free time to make sure that in a debate, we have a wide breadth and depth of knowledge that we can draw on for examples. This can be done through constantly reading and being intellectually voracious and curious in the way we approach debates. Thank you for listening to this short video, and I hope that within this trying time, you'll continue to keep a sense of humor and a love for debating. Thank you.